Good evening. Welcome to everybody and for sitting through the talks so far. They've been great. I'm going to talk about American exceptionalism. I was hoping the slides are going through. I'm not one of those people that can chew gum, talk, and read, and do everything at this or walk at the same time, so they're timed. In the past few weeks, American exceptionalism has been in the news and the media and discussed quite frequently. And it's kind of an understanding of all things American. Many who champion this concept have recently attacked U.S. history teachers for their version of how they teach U.S. history under the AP or Advanced Placement framework. Particularly citing the threat of the rising left, states like Oklahoma, Georgia, Texas, and others have kind of challenged the very essence of our education, of which I would see as a study of history, and really have attacked the AP structure. For lawmakers, state officials, and private citizens, the teaching of American history has somehow gotten away from teaching true and the real American history and talk all about the failures of our nation. Proponents use the term American exceptionalism to support a much more positive view of history and one that is opposed to kind of new interpretations and versions, or one that historians would refer to as dead white men. That interpretation of dead white men by historians, right or left, has long since been discarded. And recently, the state of Oklahoma and its Maine and one of its representatives, Dan Fisher, came under fire for addressing American exceptionalism. And they heard arguments for what they considered to be the threat of everything, which was the AP exam. And Fisher stated that the AP exam somehow made America a history now of oppressors and exploiters with undue emphasis on slavery and Native Americans, and which undermined our true study of history. What these lawmakers failed to realize that the AP framework is simply that, just a guide to teachers and students, making sure they're ready to take the test. Teachers have a framework for American history built into all their lesson plans, and the framework provides an opportunity for the students to pass the test and also to receive new and revised historical interpretations. Oklahoma, though, without looking at the wisdom of its teachers, decided to come up with its own set of documents students should study and made a list of more than 50 primary source documents they thought every student should know. And as a result then, this list, though, is pretty much, with the exception of maybe five, taught in every American history class across the country. And so maybe their problem in Oklahoma is not so much the documents they're teaching, but the interpretation that the teachers have been giving. In an era when politicians, clergymen, and the average citizen has somehow erroneously concluded that we are a nation founded on Christianity and the founding documents also, the founding fathers, the Constitution, the Declaration of Independence, founded on Christianity, they've taken exception when historians, teachers, and some textbooks state otherwise. With this exceptional view glorifies the importance of religion in colonial America and its nation building, the standard and acceptable historical interpretation is one that we removed religion from our government to avoid the problems of Europe and to hopefully not repeat any of the issues that the colonists left Europe for. And so maybe this idea of American exceptionalism is just really an misinterpretation of the facts. But what if we change our mindset? I don't know how we'll convince Oklahoma, but and tell them that American history should be all about the good, the bad, the ugly, and everything about American history. Include everything. Not just the dead white men or the white Protestant male view, but maybe it should also include the history of Tecumseh, Sacagawea, Joseph Hernandez, Frederick Douglass, Sojourner Truth, Crazy Horse, Sitting Bull, George Washington Carver, W.E.B. Du Bois, I have a list, Carrie Chapman Catt, Ben Kuroki, Wilma Rudolph, Joan Baez, Patsy Mink, Cesar Chavez, Dolores Huerta, Tommy Smith, John Carlos, Dalip Singh, Shirley Chisholm, Betty Friedan, Huey Newton, Ellison Onorzaka, Russell Means, Geraldine Ferraro, Sarah Palin, and Barack Obama. You might have recognized some of those names. Hopefully you would if you took a history class. Historian professors and, yes, even public school teachers glorify all of American history. That's what makes it exceptional. It's what we include, not exclude, that makes the study of history important and necessary in today's society. By covering all of American history, including the history of oppressors and exploiters, students learn not just the history of dead white men, but also that several million Native Americans were here on the continent before the English, the French, the Spanish, and anyone else arrived to take all their land and resources, trample their beliefs, and somehow reduce a civilization of 9 million to less than a few hundred thousand by 1900 on a minuscule portion of land where there are no way to provide for themselves, no beaver, no buffalo, no grasslands, no jobs, no hunting, no opportunity, and no education. Or maybe we should look at 400,000 African slaves that became a population of 4 million by 1860, enslaved in the American South, fought over in the Civil War, freed by the 13th Amendment, given freedom rights in the 14th and 15th Amendments in the 1860s, Civil Rights Acts from 1866 through 1968, Voting Rights Act in 1965, and several U.S. Supreme Court cases, beginning with Brown versus Board of Education, that espoused African-American rights, but none of those really followed into society. We are still a society or a history of exclusion rather than inclusion. So, what do we do today? You might be surprised to know that I'm going to suggest you all take a history class, and particularly an American history class, and one that looks at everything and prepares you for society, politics, if you want to be a lawyer, everything. High school students who are lucky enough to take the advanced placement get something beyond their small little community. Those of you that don't take advanced placement, guess what? Here you are. Now you're ready to take American history, American experience. Here we go. And you can take it at the college level. You can find out that maybe history should not be that unnecessary burden of society and education, but maybe it should be that enthusiastic, energetic, exciting requirement that every student should take. At a time maybe when history is kind of poo-pooed across campus as not being important, I'm going to say it's important. The study of history should push for inclusion, not exclusion. We need to change our view of American exceptionalism and push for the inclusion of all Americans. Without American history that examines all of America, we lose sight of the wisdom we have to explore history and provide people with knowledge and context, not just for college courses, but the greater world. At a time in American history and society when inclusion is important, we have, after all, the first African-American president, the first Latina U.S. Supreme Court justice, the first Asian-American female U.S. senator, and the first Native American female U.S. district court judge sitting now all in history. Exclusion is no longer an option. We are no longer just a history of dead white men, but a vibrant history of all American people, and our history courses should reflect the same. For those states, I'm almost there. For those states and locales that prescribe to the idea of American exceptionalism and inclusion, make 2015 the year of American exceptionalism and inclusion. Allow students a view of our entire history, the good, the bad, the ugly, as well as all longstanding historical interpretation of oppression and exploitation that acknowledges the grievances experienced by American, examines the ugly aspects of American history, and places all of our history within an exceptional past, an exceptional history, and includes the good, the bad, and the ugly. Thank you.